have to continue to fight the good fight of faith, even in the midst of what's going on right now. This is a time of judgment, but believers in Christ have to know that it's time to fight. We have weapons that enable us to not only fight, but to be victorious. Amen. So as we prepare to start our service, our praise team coming forth, I want to pray this prayer with you. I'm glad for those of you that have been able to come and gather around. Glad for you. And again, you do not have to get out your cars. Do whatever seems right to you in order for you to keep yourself and your family safe. Almighty God, our Father, in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, you are God, you are our Father. We are your people, we're dependent upon you. Without you, Lord, we can do nothing. And Lord, behold the attack that has come upon your people, that has come upon your church. I know that you see it. I know that you are aware of it. I know, Lord God, that you have a plan, even in the midst of all that's going on. You have a plan, you have a purpose. And so now I pray, Lord God, that you would open the eyes of our understanding, that you would help us to discern and understand the things that are going on around us, the things that are attacking us, the things that are coming against us. Open up the eyes of our understanding and show us, oh God, how we are to walk and how we are to carry ourselves and what things we should do as people of faith, as believers in your gospel. Show us the things that we must do in this day and time. Let the power of the Holy Ghost rest, rule, and abide in our lives. Let the power of the Holy Ghost take control in our lives, in our homes, in our fellowship, in the name of Jesus. We still look to you as our healer, as the strength of our life, to take control of our bodies, to bring healing, to help us with our finances, to direct us, to lead us, to guide us. In the name of Jesus. Father, we give you the praise and honor as we commence with this service. We ask your blessings to be upon every person, every soul. Bless the praise team. Bless the speaker. Thy will be done, O God. Edify, comfort, exhort, strengthen. In the name of Jesus, let your anointing prevail. Glorify your name in the midst of us. In Jesus Christ's name. Amen, amen, amen. Praise the Lord. God bless you. Our praise team is coming. Amen. Why don't you blow your horns to welcome our praise team as they come.
Down at the cross where my Savior died, down where from cleansing from sin I cried, there to my heart was the blood applied. Glory be to his name. I am so completely saved from sin. Glory to his name. miracle worker, way maker, 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 miracle worker. Even when I can't see that you're working, even when I can't feel that you're working, you never stop working, you never stop working. Even when I can see that you're working, even when I can feel that you're working, you never stop, you never stop working, you never stop, you never stop working.
With me when I'm standing in the fire, I will not be overcome. Through the valley of the shadow, I will not fear. I am not
Praise the Lord, everybody. And everybody, praise the Lord. Hallelujah, amen. Amen. Praise the Lord. From the rising of the sun to the going down of the same.
Yes, Lord.
Amen. The name of the Lord is worthy to be praised.
Yes,
would you say so this morning?
Yes.
Hallelujah. Thank God for another day. Thank God for a beautiful day.
Amen.
Amen. It ain't too hot.
Yes.
It ain't too cold.
Amen.
But as the three Americans say, it's just right.
Yes.
It's just right. Now I thank God this morning for allowing me to rise up out of my bed, closing my right mind with the word of God in my heart. Couldn't sleep last night. Amen. Word of God was dealing with me all last night. Started last Sunday. God spoke to me last Sunday, so I got up, wrote it down. Amen. And I said, I'm ready this morning. Amen. Didn't even know what my wife got saying this morning. But you know, sometimes when she's saying and I speak, stuff lines up. Amen. Praise the Lord. But I pray this morning that you came this morning to be blessed.
Amen.
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 Praise the Lord. If you came to be blessed this morning, just give me one honk. There we go. We looking good. Praise the Lord. Amen. How beautiful. The Bible say, how beautiful. How good and pleasant it is for brothers to dwell together in unity.
Amen.
Praise the Lord. Amen. I'm not going to be before you long this morning, thus said the Lord. Now, you did get what I said, right?
Amen.
I say, I won't be before you long this morning. But if God kicks in, amen, I have no control over that. I won't go with the flow this morning. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Amen. But this morning, nothing new. Amen. The song say, this is just a rehearsal. Amen. But scripture, where I'm going to be talking on today, you already done heard it. Amen. But I'm going on to the word of God this morning. Amen. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. We as people of God, it's time for you and I to get busy about our Father's business. Amen. You know, we've been free. I would say this. We've been free ever since March. God has given us all this much time and space. What have we done with it? Amen. You can't say, well, I was busy, I didn't have too much time. See, but right now, like I said, being this coronavirus out, we all got time, amen. We got time that we can seek the Lord, that we can pray, that we can fast, amen. We can't do too much coming together, but we still can pray and intercede for one another, amen. Praise the Lord. Amen. Like I said, I'm going to go right on into my scripture today. First of all, I want to look at 2 Corinthians chapter 5, verse 17. And it states, therefore, if any man be in Christ, he is a new creature. Old things are passed away. Behold, all things are becoming new. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Amen. And this from here, I want to tie it in with that one. Amen. And it's coming from the book of Philippians, chapter 3, verse 14. Paul addressed us. He told us, he said, forgetting those things which are behind. Yeah, forgetting those things which are behind and reaching forward unto those things which are before me. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. And if I would give you a topic for today, my topic would be, let it go. Let it go. Paul told us to forget those things. Amen. Forget means what? forgive me. Don't bring it back up. Don't say nothing about it. If God forgive you, forgiven me and you, amen, we shouldn't bring this thing up. Forget those things that are behind. But somewhere in the body of Christ, we don't seem to get there. Bible said, forget those things that are behind. Folks talk about you, lie on you, mistreat you, falsely accuse you. Forget them. You got to forget these things. We're living too close, saints, in the final hour. There's so much has taken place in this here year. Amen. And yet, there's more to come. The Bible lets us know in Matthew 24, amen, the 24th chapter, amen, these are the beginning of sorrow. As you, as a lady, you know that when you carrying a child, amen, those birth pains start to hit you sooner or later, right? Best later than sooner, because they ain't going to hit you sooner. It's going to be later. But when those birth pains start to hit you, you have no control over those, amen? Amen? But the Word of God wants you and I to forget those things, to forget what this one said about you, to forget what that one said about you, because I look and see it this way. You got to stand just like I got to stand. Amen. You got to stand before God. You got to give an account for your life. I got to give an account for my life. I got to give an account for the Word of God, what God has charged me, put me in charge of. So, saints, it behooves you and me to let, the Bible says, let no man, woman, boy, girl, don't let nobody take your crown. Yeah. Amen? Yeah. Praise the Lord. Word of God also let me know that the devil come to steal, to kill, and to destroy. But my God say, I have come that you and I might have life, and that life, that we might have that life more abundantly. Amen. Praise the Lord. Look at your neighbor, say, neighbor, let it go.
Let it go.
I don't care what it is, let it go. If it's your children, if it's your husband, yeah, if it's your wife, yeah, let it go. Amen. You done been around that mountain too many times. It's time to let it go. Word of God told me to tell you to cast all of your cares upon him. Because God cares for you. Amen. Nobody else cares for you like God can care for you. I can do so much. God ain't gonna allow me to do but so much. But this one God wants us, the Bible says, trust in the Lord. Trust in the Lord with all of your heart. Lean not to your own understanding. But in all of your ways, in everything that you do, in every time that you turn around, if you acknowledge God, I guarantee you, God will direct your path. Amen. You know, this is the time of the year. I know you probably have got some as well as myself. But this is the time of the year. It's a tricky time. Amen. These loan companies will send you a letter in the mail to let you know if it's $1,500, $1,000. But if you ain't wise, you'll fall for it. And there you go, 3 or 4 years, paying off $1,500. The devil heals a lie, amen? Because my God say he'll supply all of my needs according to his riches and glory by Christ Jesus. Praise the Lord. Amen. Praise the Lord. You got to let it go, saints. You've been holding on this thing too long. Amen. A mother can't hold that child so long. You know, I was looking yesterday. I tell my grandson a lot of times, and not all my grandson, but a whole lot of you need to tune in to this channel. Channel 7 at 9 o'clock and watch Earth Odyssey. Amen. Praise the Lord. You know what? The oldest mammal in this world that can carry a baby 22 months is an elephant. Amen. 22 months. Amen. Just think about it, mom out there. Suppose you had to carry that child 22 months. Amen. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. But the devil, but you gotta let, you got something, you just gotta let it go. You cannot continue to go as you go. Amen. The Bible said, the word of God say, and where is it? Praise the Lord. Okay. The word of God let us know in 1 Corinthians 9:24. Know ye not that they which run in a race, run all, but one receive the prize. So run that ye may obtain it. We're in a race. You and I is in a race. Amen. I've been in this race now going on 38 years. Amen. And I haven't got tired yet. Amen. It's the good one thing about it, when you're in a race, you got to run with a pace. You cannot start out running wide open and you got 5 left to go. You ain't going to make it the first lap. You got to bounce, so you got to run with patience and you got to look unto Jesus. You got to look to the end of the finish line. Amen. Mama might done gone on. Brother might done gone on. That race is over. That race is over for them. But you and I are still in this race. And I promise I'm going to hold out. Amen. I refuse to give up. Because my God is an awesome God. My God can do exceedingly above all that you and I could ever think and ask, according to the power that worketh in you. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. What a mighty God we serve. What a mighty God we serve. Praise the Lord. Hebrews 12:1 said, wherefore, seeing we also are compassed about with so great cloud of witness, let us lay aside every weight and every sin which do so easily beset us, and let us run with patience. Run with patience now, this race that is set before us. Know why we got to run with patience? Because it ain't going to end just like this. You got to have patience. Yeah. And then a lot of people now, they ain't got patience with nothing. They ain't got patience with nobody. They ain't got patience with the dog. They can go out there and try to feed the dog. If the dog get barking, they'll walk back in the house. Well, you need to shut up. You need to feed the dog. You feed him, I guarantee you he'll shut up. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. But we as people of God, we gotta run with patience. We gotta have patience. The Bible said let patience have its perfect work in you and I. Hallelujah. Thank God for the word of God. Amen. The word of God is strength. The word of God is my salvation. The word of God is my healing. You know, on this, look, I'm looking back. This is November. Looking back at September. Hallelujah. The enemy came into my mother's house. See, I told you the devil come to steal and to kill and destroy. But mama looked at him and told the devil, you is a lie. My mama let the devil know, I shall not die, but I shall live and declare the works of the Lord. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. You got to let it go, saints. You got to let it go. If you and I is planning on to gain ground, amen, something we got to let go. We got to lay it aside. Amen. You got to lay it aside. If my wife don't want to go, if my children don't want to go, I can't lose sleep over that. Only thing I can do, I can pray for you. Bible said, pray ye one for another. Amen. Praise the Lord. The word of God says that we are to build one another. We are to encourage one another. We are to edify one another. We are not to bite one another. We are not to false accuse one another. Amen. But we are to love as Christ has loved. If you say you got Christ in you, and Christ, you say you got the love of God in you, amen. Why don't you love me like you say you love me? Amen. I don't need a counterfeit love. need a genuine love. I need an unfailing love. I need an unconditional love. I need for you to love me. Amen. I need for you to love me when folks are talking about me. I need for you to love me when things are going right. Even if I rebuke you, I need for you to love me. Because the Bible says, open rebuke is better than secret love. Sometimes you and I need it. Sometimes you and I need to be openly rebuked. Amen. Then we might straighten up and walk right. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Amen. I don't know what you're going to get with me or no today. But look, regardless of what you get with me or not, see, because one thing I know, I got to deliver the word of God as God has given unto me. Matthew 5:12. Blessed are ye when men shall revile you and persecute you and say all manner of evil against you falsely for my sake. What the word of God say? He said, rejoice and be exceedingly glad. He didn't say, I'm going to get him later. I'm going to pay him back. When I get up there, I'm going to pay him back. Oh, you don't do an eye for an eye. Amen. You kill my dog. Amen. I ain't going to say nothing about a cat because I ain't got that cat. Amen. You ain't going to mess with my dog. Hallelujah. He going to stand for himself. Hallelujah. But we as people of God, we got to show one another, look, I need the song, say, I remember the song years ago. I need you and you need me. Hallelujah. What a shame it would be if we let this love go free. But I need you, and you definitely need me. Amen?
Amen.
Hallelujah. So, saints, let us get this thing right. Let us let these things go. Anything that hinder you, anything that you don't need, let it go. Anything that's going to keep me out of heaven, I'm going to let it go. Because the word of God said, only the pure and righteousness shall see God. Only the pure and righteousness shall see God. I don't know about you, but I'm living that I might live again. I'm living that I might be a light. Because the Bible said we are the light of the world. We are the salt of the earth. Folks are looking at you and they're looking at me. Like I said, we are living in the last day. Folks turning from this, they turn it to that. They turn it to everything so God. Amen. They'll try this, they'll try that. They'll try anything so God. Most times the last thing they'll do, they'll cry God. But my thing is, if I try God first, I won't have to worry about how none of this other stuff work out. Amen. You got to try God. The Bible says, oh, taste and see that the Lord is good. Amen?
Amen.
How many of you, but some of you ain't tasted. You know, you can hear folks talk about, you know, I don't like this. I don't like that. Have you tried it? Have you tasted it? You never know what you like till you try it, till you taste it. Hallelujah. But I guarantee, if you try and taste Jesus, I guarantee you never saw him say, I'll never let go of his hand. I'll never let go. You might knock me down. You might trample on me. You might lie on me. You might say all manner of evil against me falsely. But it ain't going to make me come down. It's going to make me stand. It's going to make me get that much stronger. Because the Bible says, strong in the Lord and the power of his might. See, because one thing, when I get up, I put on the whole armor. If I'm going to go out, I'm going to dress occasion to what I got to do. Army man, he put on the whole army. Amen. And you and I, we is in the army of God. We sang this song. I'm a soldier in the army of the Lord. We act like it. Can't you take some order? Can't you take a little discipline? Amen. If you're a soldier, you're going to take some discipline. That's the first thing you're going to do. When you come into the army, they're going to learn you. They're going to teach you how to act. Now, when you were home, you might disrespect mama. You might disrespect daddy. But now, what the chronicle say, now you is my child. You is my boy. You're going to do what I say do, when I say do, and how I say do. Not only that, but not only those in the army, but incarceration. It's the same way. Amen. You're not your own. The Bible says you're not your own. You and I, we were bought with a price. A price that you and I could not pay. Amen. Hallelujah. So I thank God for the blood. Because it was the blood that reached back. 1983, the month February, the day I'm not for sure, but I know it was February 1983. God stepped into my life. The song said, you and I sang this song, I won't turn back. Are you sure? Are you sure you won't turn back? Sometimes we say things, then the next thing you know, well, where's brother Moose? Sister Coon. They throw it in the towel. Somebody lied on them. Somebody false mistreated them. They throw, you can't take nothing. We are saying now, we look like we getting weaker. But my God, he's mighty in power. He's strong in battle. Hallelujah. Thank God for strength. Thank God, because he's able to keep this old boy from falling. Anything else, I'm going to fall. But if I stand on the word of God, I'm surely to can maintain. Saints, I got one more scripture, and I'm going to cut you loose. Amen. 1 Corinthians 13 and 11 says, when I was a child, I spoke as a child. When I was a child, I spoke as a child. But when I became a man, I put away childish things. And when you became a woman, you put away childish things. I wouldn't want to go in the house, come to the house tonight, and I pull up, there my wife got a T-set, playing with some doll baby. Give it to your granddaughter. They don't even play with doll baby no more. Amen. But when I became a man, I knew I was a man. When I became a man, I put away childish things, what folks said about me. I didn't worry about it, because I knew, the Bible let me know, that many are the affliction of the righteous. Many, he said, not many, he didn't say few. He said, many are the affliction of the righteous. But God promised that he would deliver me out of them all. So it don't, look, you can talk all you want to. From somebody, folks say, talk don't make me, talk don't bother me. It don't bother me. It don't, look, it ain't gonna bother me. See, cause what you say, I ain't got to give an account to it if I don't respond to it. That's the main thing. If I don't respond to it. And most times, I tell folks, when I respond to anybody, it's going to be edifying, encouraging, or building up. Anything else, I can't go that way. Because I got one day, I know this old boy got to lay down. And I got to stand before my master and give an account to him. So I don't want when God, when it's all said and done, when I'm laying up the scratch before you all, and y'all think, well, he did this and he did that. He was a good boy. I don't hear nothing you say. If you love me, let me know it. Show me that you love me. Show me that you care. Show me that you're concerned about me. Amen. Don't wait till I'm scratched out, don't know nothing about it. If you love me, Bob said, if you love me, you'll keep my commandment. And this commandment is that we love one another as Christ had loved you. So saints, I thank God for you today. But remember, you gotta let it go. I don't care what it is, let it go. If your husband, if your wife, if your children, let them go. Cast them on God. Put them in God's hand. And watch God bring that thing to pass. God bless you. And I love you. And keep on keeping on. Be steadfast. Unmovable. Always abounding in the work of the Lord. For as you and I know, that our labor is not in vain in the work of the Lord. God bless you.